project I worked on a number of years ago. It was an undersized pipe. The stream had not seen any fish in it that we knew of for a long, long time. We went in, removed the structure, put a bridge in, looked down in the river, and lo and behold, there was salmon, big salmon, swimming up the river. You know, this is why we're all doing this. Look at what we're seeing here. There hasn't been fish in this stream in 100 years, and here we are seeing, you know, large salmon in this stream right now. Forest and fish came into effect because of the standards that were in place at the time. There was a recognition, one, that the salmon populations were on the decline, and they were trying to figure out in those days what the primary cause of that was. With that, that also brought into the fact that all the crossings that we have, road crossings, that were not providing fish passage needed to be upgraded to provide fish passage, because that goes into the whole thing of habitat above and the ability for fish to spawn. So identification of these structures that need to be fixed are typically identified by the outfall of the culvert. Typically the outfall of the culvert has a elevation difference between what natural water level is and what the actual stream level is. So in this situation, we're putting a large culvert in, get that stream channel to look the same or better than what the existing stream channel looks like, and then over time for it to mimic it exactly. And that's what we're ultimately looking for, and provide passability for fish and any other amphibian species that are using the stream channels.
Today we put the pipe in the ground, but obviously we had it excavated ahead of time. Water diversion, we try to do minimal anything in the water, so we set the pipes, dig everything ahead of time, and then block the channel and let the water flow natural into the diversion pipes and take that downstream, so there is no sediment delivery. Well, the goal is just to enhance the, you know, open up the fish passage, because for so long the passages have not been passable, the pipes, so that's what we do, is we restore it so they can move above and below the roads.
On some of these streams where there's fish that are already downstream and they're hanging out there, that, you know, when they're diverting the water for the project and then they put the water back, and as soon as it runs over that fresh sediment, that the fish will just immediately swim right up and check it out. And it's really exciting to see them go up and use this, you know, new habitat that they haven't been able to see before. It's been really good working with Rainier. We definitely, you know, we try to work together because saving the environment is important. We all have that goal. So having that open communication and trust has been really great.
This particular project had two culverts in it, two old culverts, undersized, causing fish blockage. Inside the culvert, the rock will be low in the middle for what they would consider a low flow channel. You know, you could easily say that, is this really gonna work? Is this really doing its job? You go back and you see a fish in these culverts, it just proves to you that your work is meaning something. It's only gonna get better.